I say, you know, that's the home base, you know, that's the crib. Realest thing you come across, you know, that's the bridge. Listen, son, my lucky number is 718. Can't question our hunger, we leave a plate clean. From the hood to Hollywood, then we went back. We just wanted to shine and then it went black. Brooklyn, put your lighters up. That's a sign that your day can brighten up. We been shining, y'all just wasn't looking yet. The association, Brooklyn Nets. Nice.
Hello, Brooklyn.
Like Brooklyn swagger. People stop me in the street, say, where you from? I don't say I'm from New York, I say I'm from Brooklyn. Right. That's right, Brooklyn, that's how we do, right? Baby. No doubt. There's a spirit. When you come from Brooklyn, you gotta make it. I'm proud to know that we got a sports team again. My elders will tell me about the Dodgers and what Ebbetsville used to be and how much pride people from Brooklyn had when it was here, you know, but I never thought that I would live to see an arena being built here. Man, this thing is going to bring so much pride to our borough.
Brooklyn pride began almost 400 years ago when the area was first settled. Today, my borough is one of the five in NYC. But by itself, it would be the fourth largest city in the country. The Nets are part of the future, but here, there's a strong connection to the past.
Well, let me give you a little bit of history here. In Brooklyn, we defended against the British first. In Brooklyn, Walt Whitman brought the arts. In Brooklyn, all the immigrants crossed over to the borough and were able to have a decent life. That's where the pride first generated from. It comes from all those immigrants. It comes from all those artists. It comes from all those fighters. And then, in saying all that, that's such a wonderful thing, the city would still crap on us.
Just across the East River is another borough, Manhattan. It gets most of the attention, which rubs a lot of us the wrong way.
When I was a boy, we rarely went into Manhattan. What has Manhattan got that Brooklyn doesn't have?
France even built us the Grand Army Plaza. They put it in Brooklyn. Holla.
Brooklyn was also the scene of a revolutionary moment in sports. In 1947, Jackie Robinson broke baseball's color barrier. Everybody here loved Jackie and the Dodgers, who put the borough in the national spotlight.
I grew up three blocks away from Ebbets Field. So the Dodgers were ingrained in me from birth. The Brooklyn Dodgers exemplified everything that Brooklyn was, all of our strengths and some of our weaknesses.
Fans called them them bums. They always seemed to lose when it mattered most, especially to the city's other teams. In 1951, they had their hearts broken by the Giants in the famous shot heard round the world. And when they lost in the World Series over and over to the hated Yankees, Brooklyn fans still looked on the bright side.
Wait till next year, because we never stopped believing that next year we would win the World Series.
In 1955, they finally did it. And nothing was sweeter than beating the Yankees.
The Dodgers waited 40 years for this day, and at long last, they're world champions. This is next year.
It was like a weight had come off of Brooklyn, and that finally, Brooklyn got the respect that we were always yearning for.
just 2 years later, the Dodgers packed up and left town. Brooklynites felt betrayed, and a void remained in the borough's soul for over two generations.
For people who live in Brooklyn who are sports fans, they say, you know what? You know, my dad, it's been burning him for years that the Dodgers were gone. He never got over it.
There's nothing but apartments where Ebbetsville used to be. But now, there's a new building in the borough and a team to go with it, and the Nets are bringing hope.
We always longed that one day Brooklyn would be back in national sports. So when we had the groundbreaking, it was sort of like the long wait is over. This is finally happening.
Is Brooklyn in the house? I thought so. You know, 2.5 years ago, we all helped break ground on this arena. And today we've come back to celebrate with all of you everything that this proud day means for Brooklyn and for New York.
When the Barclays Center opened up in September, it meant that Brooklyn is back. And the sports world is about to learn something we knew all along.
Brooklyn has a character that doesn't exist maybe anyplace else in the world. And you're going to see an outpouring, I think, of Brooklyn to support this team like no other place ever.
After more than 50 years, Brooklyn finally has its own team again. And the Nets have found a place to put down roots. The team has had a checkered past, which includes playing in seven different buildings. And in Brooklyn, they're going to try to bring back the magic they had in the 70s.
The Nets have won the NBA championship.
That's when Dr. J was the man.
It's as sweet as it ever was. I tell you, now hopefully this is, we've started something and we can keep on winning some more championships in the years to come. And we're going to enjoy this one right now. Have a little champagne.
After joining the NBA, the Nets made it to the finals a couple of times. But there aren't many happy memories from their 35 years out in Jersey.
I think if you could put the Nets' history into a single word, it might just be amorphous. Who are the New Jersey Nets? They were a team that was good occasionally, terrible often, moved around a lot. They never really had an identity.
When construction began on the Barclays Center, the team tried to envision a brighter future.
This is the jump circle right here?
Yeah.
More like right there. It's been so long since they really had a team to cheer for. So we're looking for the best home court in the league and really just making it boom in Brooklyn.
When the Nets get to Brooklyn, they're just gonna have this.
Like that.
Brooklyn puts something in you. It does. It makes you have like.
And being from Brooklyn, which we are,
yeah.
It's special, extra
That's
for
right.
us.
It's a chance to be the birth of something.
Getting there.
All that is exciting because I think we all heard it. We all talk how big it's gonna be. And I've never been part of something that went from ground up to now.
As construction continued, Nets general manager Billy King needed to build a team worthy of this new arena. And his first job was to sign his own free agent, all-star point guard Deron Williams.
I never really asked him, like, are you coming back? It was more of just showing him.
And one way to show him was to bring another superstar to Brooklyn, Dwight Howard of the Orlando Magic.
Clearly, Deron Williams and Dwight Howard wanted to play with each other. They'd obviously communicated that to each other, and I think there was some risk. What if this doesn't happen? You know, will Deron Williams want to stay on a team without Dwight Howard?
Dwight Howard is still with the Orlando Magic, but it appears a trade to the Brooklyn Nets is gaining momentum.
The Brooklyn Nets offered the Orlando Magic a trade.
For the better part of a year, King pursued a deal.
No, I definitely won't do that.
Along the way, we kept contacting them and talking, and nothing new.
The pressure was on. The GM was trying to reel in two stars. At this point, he had none.
Billy King had a tough job to do because what are you selling Deron Williams on? The roster's in flux. The team is in flux. You know, this is not an easy proposition. And I think that's
what Michael. Then King caught a lucky break, but it didn't come from Orlando.
Let's make the right decisions to try to win that championship.
Danny Ferry gets the job in Atlanta, and I just called to congratulate him, and we talked, and then at the end of the conversation, he says, would you have interest in Joe Johnson?
Joe Johnson is a six-time All-Star. King was interested enough to make the deal. He didn't make it public right away, but he did let Deron Williams in on the news.
Well, the first thing I said, I want you to know, we have Joe Johnson done, and he goes, I haven't heard anything about that. I go, exactly, because I wanted you to know first.
Billy was catching a lot of flack, from the press and from fans. And, he's a big reason why I'm still here, why I decided to stay.
Deron, it seemed to me, kind of looking for a reason to stay. But basketball-wise, before they got Joe, it was hard to find a reason. Billy King to save it from what could have been a disaster if Deron Williams had left.
Two big pieces had fallen into place for Billy King. But it turns out that one of them had played a major role in this drama all along.
The one thing, Deron did say to me before free agency started, he says, please don't just wait on Dwight. He says, because, if we can't wait and not have a team.
We couldn't stand and wait on any situation that wasn't 100%. We didn't want to get left at the altar.
The team of Brooklyn is bigger than one person. My job, I owed it to the organization, I owed it to our fans, I owed it to Deron and the players that, we got to build for Brooklyn, and we went forward and built our team.
Now that Billy King's finished his work and put a pretty respectable team together, Avery Johnson has the next biggest task. The clock really starts for him now, too.
Yeah! Brooklyn!
We know that we're Brooklyn and we're special. Brooklyn is not for everyone, and we don't want everyone.
Everybody, is proud people. Well-groomed.
Brooklyn, the best place in the world to come to.
What are we doing? We're talking or we're eating over here?
If you're sleeping, you'll get run over.
If you're from Brooklyn, it's hard to hide it. You talk about the Brooklyn Nets. When you bring the subject up, the smiles come on people's faces. The excitement comes in their voices. It's almost a new legacy about to be started here.
Now, we're only laying the foundation. You gotta stay with me now. We're only laying the foundation.
Nets head coach Avery Johnson carries the weight of expectation, but he's fought his way to this point, and Brooklyn loves a fighter.
The way my career has evolved, I've always been in kind of the underdog role. I came into the NBA in 1988 as an undrafted rookie, and had to try out for a team where there was only one spot available with the Supersonics.
Pretty little pass. Avery's a creative distributor.
My whole career bouncing around and getting cut and getting traded and trying to prove people wrong, I had some hard days.
With the San Antonio Spurs, he finally got a chance to show everybody what he's made of. They didn't call him the little general for nothing.
Yo, fist out three! Fist out three! Get out! Get out!
And in the 1999 finals, he proved what he could do when the pressure's on.
Avery Johnson for the lead, yes! The San Antonio Spurs win their first ever NBA championship.
Yes, sir! Yes, sir! I've been at this for 11 years!
Less than a year after retiring as a player, he was made head coach of the Dallas Mavericks. And a season after that, he was the NBA's coach of the year. But the ride ended when his Mavericks fell two wins short of a title.
And the Miami Heat are champions of the basketball world!
Mavericks season ends in heartbreaking fashion on their home floor.
Avery Johnson is still having to essentially reestablish himself as a coach in this league. When he took over that Dallas team, again, it was a pretty well-established team, and he got them to the finals. It's that next job that starts to define you then. Now that Billy King's finished his work and put a pretty respectable team together, this is all falling on Avery Johnson.
The pressure's always been there. There's no different. I actually like this pressure better, okay? I want to be in a situation where we're in the playoffs and everything is scrutinized, every possession, every quarter, every interview. I don't want to be at home watching other teams and coaches under that sort of pressure.
Pressure. In Brooklyn, we have our own ways of working out the tension and replacing it with new energy. And it looks like the Nets are starting to catch on.
The core of the team has been here for about 2.5 weeks now. Guys like Deron, we've had for the whole offseason. They're in phenomenal shape right now.
We know we got a lot of work to do, but we're excited about the whole rebranding, relocating of a team. We're not the New Jersey Nets anymore. We're the Brooklyn Nets. We're in a different state, different era, different colors, different team, and we feel we have a chance now to forge our own path.
Welcome to Gersh Park.
Easy Rock Brooklyn.
Hard, determination, it's tough, fire.
This is where we born, this is where we raised, this is where we bleed. Brooklyn, toughness, that's it.
The Nets gonna be all right. They're gonna play with so much energy and heart just from the crowd.
Please raise your hand and we'll get to as many people as we can. Okay, right over here first.
Have you been here before? What do you know of Brooklyn?
I didn't know anything about it, but.
Can't really blame him. Joe Johnson is from Arkansas, but now he's being introduced to Brooklyn by one of our own.
Meet your new Brooklyn Nets.
How y'all doing?
Nice. Welcome.
How you doing?
Hopefully you do some amazing things for New York, right?
Definitely. I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah.
To me, the beauty of the neighborhood is not just the tree-lined blocks or the brownstones. It's the beautiful people. It's the warm people. It's the real people.
You running the court?
No, shit. Joe Johnson, just come to the park and play ball with us.
I wanted to bring Joe around the neighborhood so that the neighborhood can say, all right, you're here, you're ours, let's do this.
Every New York sports star gets his start somewhere. And for 75 years, future champs have paid their dues at Gleason's Gym.
Welcome to Brooklyn, man. You're going to win this year?
Oh, definitely.
All right.
Definitely.
Okay, you're in a winning place.
He went into Gleason's Gym, the history that he saw, all the champions that came out of that gym.
Here's Ali, when he's known as Cassius Clay.
This is Mike Tyson when he's 14 years old.
I couldn't get him out of Gleason's Gym. Once they put those gloves on him, forget about it.
Give me one.
Come on, man. Always lead with the left. All in the jab. Just keep working the jab. Make Brooklyn proud.
Just to be a part of Brooklyn, raise some eyebrows as far as what's expected of us in Brooklyn Nets.
I just loved how people just were so real with him.
Too much talking, not enough training. Come on.
Even myself, I said, my goodness, you talk slow as hell. He goes, yeah, you just say whatever comes to your mind. And I go, welcome to Brooklyn, get used to it.
Joe Johnson and the Nets are the new kids in town. But out in Coney Island, there's a minor league ballpark where memories of the beloved Dodgers are still as fresh as ever.
Hi, big guy.
Biggie.
Good seeing you.
How are you, man?
Oh, I love you.
Love you. Good to see you.
Likewise.
There that is. See that? Jackie was the right man at the right place to do the right job.
We're going out to the field again, Ralphie.
That won't happen anymore, pig.
No, I know.
It was a special team and a special time. to think of that ballpark and the fans and how nice they were. And always brings back pleasant memories.
I played for the Brooklyn Dodgers, and I caught the last game in Ebbets Field. Just being a Brooklyn boy, to me that means a lot, because there's no other kid in Brooklyn that could say that.
There's one thing that pro athletes in Brooklyn learn early. If you represent the borough well, we'll love you forever.
Brooklyn fans will connect with you. If they're anything like they were 50, 60 years ago, you don't have to be anything but nice and respect the fans and just be yourself.
In Brooklyn, you're born with pride, but you gotta earn respect.
When we have opening night on November 1st, that's only going to be a product of what people don't see. There's really no true downtime.
Break, 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 run!
Brooklyn is in the building. We're here.
Never thought in my wildest dreams that I would live to see something like this come back to Brooklyn.
It's all about us. It's all about Brooklyn. Forget about it.
This is the hometown. This is home base. We have to do this as fellow Brooklynites.
I'm representing Park Slope.
Dyker Heights.
Williamsburg.
Bedford-Stuyvesant, Brooklyn.
It's more than just the city being represented. It's life itself.
You gotta block the shot, you gotta take the charge, or you gotta give me a hard foul.
We're bringing a new attitude to Brooklyn.
This is a new era for Nets basketball.
Next time on the Association, Brooklyn Nets.
All right, here we go. Let's go. Go, execute.
Introductions are over, and it's down to business.
Started training camp. Feeling out.